Hi there, I'm Brooke Baldwin. You're watching CNN on this Wednesday afternoon. Thank you so much for being with me. We're going to talk politics in just a second here, but I want to play you some sound. We have word now that the 73-year-old woman in Florida was accidentally shot and killed by police. This was all during this live gun demonstration. Apparently, there was live ammo, and she was killed. The police chief is speaking. Let's listen.
We have extended reach.
Here we go, top of the hour. You're watching CNN. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Thank you for being with me any minute. All of that coming up. In the meantime, the reaction to Trump's comments has been swift, from, you know, chalking it up to just a bad joke to labeling it a dangerous call to arms. Here is just some of the fallout. But the reaction everyone is talking about today is the one that actually happened just behind Donald Trump at that rally as the cameras were rolling. So I am going to replay Donald Trump's comments, but I want you to look not at Donald Trump, but at the man in the red just to the right of your screen. On set with me. You've got the smile, you not so much.
I think that's what's most important about what he said. Second most important is that he's agreed to
never said.
Right. But that's a little bit getting lost right now. But
I would have taken him to the shed. He's voting for him. He thinks he's intelligent.
We're glad for
his character.
We're glad for his vote, and we welcome Mr. Vickers to the Trump team. So, but more broadly, it's interesting that we're talking about him.
They didn't know.
Well, it's more.
This
is my third campaign. They knew. This is my third presidential campaign. The presidential campaign knows.
So you're suggesting he intentionally
behind.
Did it? Wait.
Have an answer for me? I'd love for you to give one.
Gloria Boardroom, I'm going to give it to you. Thank you for that. Let me bring in you two, Boris and Anna Marie, because I'm going to look at you first. Because, Listen, it's no secret. Her trustworthy numbers are in the dumps. Yeah. And when you have, again, an issue of her email server, it has to be concerning for the campaign.
What I wouldn't give for this to be, I mean, yeah, I do think corruption is part of government,
people go
pretty
to jail
much.
For corruption.
And we have a system to take
care of the specific issues in the Clinton emails now.
I would like to see more of the emails, sure.
There's three levels of issues here. One, she's obviously been lying.
In terms of giving and working with Donald Trump, I'm just trying to be
fair. When are we going to see Trump's tax
specifically? We heard from James Comey, and there will be no charges.
Right.
Given that, though, hold on. Right. These issues do continue to hit her, and I'm thinking of, listen, those who love Hillary Clinton, they're probably not changing their minds. And those who love Donald Trump, including the man in North Carolina with the red shirt,
my man Vickers,
he's voting for Trump now. He's convinced. But for the in-between, and I know the undecideds are shrinking, but do you worry when these stories continue to come out about her emails and about these connections and
info that does come out every time that we do get information? It's never from her, because she obstructs justice.
Hang
it
on.
Always makes clear that she is not above board. She's a liar and should be a convicted felon.
That's really strong language.
Yeah.
I mean every word.
Hang on. I'm not finished with either of you. I appreciate both your perspectives. Wow. Let's, though, go to Joe Johns, who has some new thinking about you. Anna Marie Cox, Boris Epstein, thank you so much. And Gloria Boardroom, Susan Page for us in Washington. Special coverage continues here on CNN just after this break.